I would like to introduce you to the Digit 3, which I'm really excited about. I love the Digit 2 because it was small and I could hook it up to my microphone to control OnSong and no one would see it. Then AirTurn discontinued it and I no longer had a small device I could recommend to people. Apparently though, they had some big ideas for this little device and created the Digit 3. This device is a bit bigger, but is still very discreet, compact, but robust in its abilities. If you would like to purchase, go to the following link, onesongapp.com/store/airturn/digit3. In the box, you will get the Digit 3, a USB to micro USB charging cord, and the user manual. Now, I've already read this for you and found the Digit 3 will need to be on mode 2 to be used within OnSong. Now, I have small hands, and you can see the Digit 3 is smaller than my hand. It is approximately 3.5 inches long, 1.25 inches wide, and 1/2 inch deep, and it's super light to boot. On the device, you will see 8 buttons, 5 of which are customizable from within OnSong. The top green button is our power button. Then we have our directional arrow buttons, up, down, left, and right. In the center, we have the play, pause, or OK button. Lastly, at the bottom, we have the keyboard button on the left and the mode key on the right. As you can also see, there are 2 bars on the left and right of the Digit 3. These enable you to attach it to varying surfaces. At the bottom, we see a loop. This allows you to attach it to your keys so that you always have your Digit with you. On the left side, you can see the charging port. Then on the back, we can see it has a concave surface. This is a great feature, especially if you want to attach this to a rounded surface, such as a microphone or a microphone stand. To get started, we need to turn the device on. Press and hold the power button until you see just the blue light blink, which should be 1 to 2 seconds. As I had mentioned before, we want this to be in mode 2. To change the mode, press and hold the mode button until the red light blinks 2 times. You will then see a red and blue light blink 2 times to indicate it is in mode 2. Now we can pair it to our iPad, iPhone, or iPod Touch. I will be using an iPad. To pair the Digit 3, tap on the Settings app on your device. From the settings list, select the Bluetooth settings. Make sure you have Bluetooth toggled to on. Then wait for the Digit 3 to appear in the Other Devices list. Tap on the Digit 3 device and tap Pair when you are prompted to. It will be listed in My Devices list and say Connected. Now we can go into OnSong and assign our different actions to the 5 programmable buttons. The directional buttons and the play pause buttons can all be programmed with an action from within OnSong. Open OnSong on your device and then tap on the foot pedal icon in the menu bar. We will now swipe right to left until we see the Digit 2 silhouette. Now, we have not gotten a new silhouette created for this awesome device, but we can still use the silhouette for the Digit 2 to assign actions to our Digit 3. To assign actions to a button, you can either press the button on the Digit 3 or tap on the button on the silhouette to bring up the actions menu. I'm going to start with the up arrow button and assign the scroll up action. Next, I will assign the down arrow button the scroll down action. The right arrow button, I will assign the next song action. And the left arrow button, the previous song action. For my center button, I will assign the send a message action and select or create the message I want to send. I'm going to choose the start message. When we are done assigning actions, you can tap close. As you can see, we can now scroll down, scroll up, go to the next song, go to the previous song, and send a message with just the press of a button. Now, you may be like me, and 5 actions are just not enough to get you through a performance. You can go back into the foot pedal menu and tap on the up arrow in the lower right-hand corner to use gears with the digit 3. This will allow you to assign multiple actions to one button. Here's a video which will go over how to set up and use gears. If you need to use your on-screen keyboard anywhere in OnSong, such as the editor, you will need to do the following. Tap and place your cursor where you want to type. If you're using OnSong, it will bring up a pop-up letting you know you need to eject your keyboard. Then press and release the power button on the digit 3 to eject the keyboard. You will only need to do this once within OnSong until you turn off your digit 3. So now we have played our set and everything went flawlessly, and we need to turn a digit 3 off. Press and hold the power button until the red and blue lights turn off, or about 1 to 2 seconds. If you want to pair your digit 3 to another device, you can reset the digit 3 by doing the following. Press and hold the power button until you see the red and blue button blink 3 times and then turn off. At that point, release the power button. Now, press and hold the power button until the device turns on again. The blue light is blinking rapidly, letting you know it is in pairing mode and is ready to be paired to another device. I hope this gives you a good idea of how to set up and use the AirTurn DIGIT III with OnSong. If you have any questions, be sure to contact us at onsongapp.com/support.